Hello ma'am, thank you for providing this opportunity. To group number two, we are presenting on the topic Kingfisher Airlines Flight the Good Times. My name is Meghna Verma and the other members of the group are Sanjana, Prabal, Lesson and Saeed. As we all know about the Kingfisher Airlines, but we would like to throw some more lights about on it. What does the company do? Kingfisher Airlines Limited was founded in 2003. Its chairman was Vijay Mallya and CEO was Sanjay Agarwal. And the headquarters was at Mumbai. The parent company of Kingfisher Airlines was United Breweries Group. Kingfisher Airlines Limited was an airline group based in India. Until December 2011, Kingfisher Airlines Limited has the second largest share in the India's domestic air travel market. For international air travel, Kingfisher Airlines Limited taken over Air Jetto. It has a 50% stake in low-cost carrier Kingfisher Air. What are its competitive dimensions? They offer a luxury journey and the cheap rate that compares to other economic airlines. It used to provide a high-quality service. It also provide other new and stylish products and obtain early mover advantage. It was the first Indian airline to have a new fleet of planes. And it used to offer lowest price in the market. The next slide will be presented by my friend Lesson.
Thank you, Meghna, for that wonderful input on the Kingfisher Airways. Yes, the Kingfisher Airways was launched in the 18th birthday of Vijay Mallya's son with a grand opening party. The promotion of 360 degree was fabulous, as never before, with new booking tickets facilities and connectivity at international levels. The services in the airlines were to be far more better than its competitors in the market. And it did had an advantage of having customers across the entire nation. The Kingfisher loyalty program had the most premium services, and earlier the company had no categories or sections of the flight. They said on board in the Kingfisher Airways is like the customers are not in the first, second or economy category. They are in the Kingfisher lifestyle.
Thank you, Blessen. And now I'm going to talk about the downfall of the Kingfisher. As you can see in the pie chart, there was a tough competition of all the players in the market and Kingfisher wanted to be on the top. Therefore, Kingfisher take over the big company, the Air Deccan, which they started flying internationally on the regular basis, which caused management dysfunctionality. It started with the operation failure, where the company lost it in controlling many prominent overhead, such as maintenance cost and added services cost. Vijay Mallya had a vision to give his customer premium experience in traveling and did forget the repeatedly increasing cost. The furthest reason of failure would be explained by my friend Sanjana Shah.
Thank you, Prabal. So my friend explained about the strategical and operational issues. Now I'll be going through marketing and branding issues, which were the among the biggest failure of Kingfisher Airlines. So for any business, the most important thing is to market its product rightly. So when the Kingfisher was launched earlier, it had a very good marketing strategy. But later on, it failed to achieve customer satisfaction. The reasons for marketing and branding issues were as follows. The first one is hierarchy of needs. It is important to fulfill the lower needs first as per the Maslow hierarchy of needs. The price was the lower first need which needs to be fulfilled. So when the Kingfisher was launched, it had launched its air ticket at a very cheaper rate. But later on, due to increasing competition of other airlines like IndiGo, GoAir, and also other factors like state government taxed at a higher rate for aviation turbine fuel. Also, the marketing and branding costs were rising day by day. Due to all such factors, the Kingfisher Airlines could not keep its air price cheaper. The next need was convenience. The airport landing and navigation charges at Indian airports were 50% higher than any other international flight, and it was highest among the world. The next was comfort. The in-flight reading materials and food were very costly of Kingfisher Airlines as compared to other airlines. Luxury. The Kingfisher Airlines focused more on providing luxury and premium products, and it provided less attention to the economic class. The next point is it ignored points of parity. As per the survey conducted, it was found that Kingfisher Airlines had 40% cheaper tickets, 20% no delay, that is, it had a delay in its flight. Free food was not provided by Kingfisher Airlines, and it charged a very high cost for the food. Leg space was also not that convenient, and services were not provided good. The next point is Kingfisher brand identity. So as per the survey, it was found that one of the segment of Kingfisher, that is Kingfisher Red, could not achieve the brand identity due to factors like price, food, comfort, delay in flights, and all such factors. The next point was brand loyalty in low-cost carrier. As per the survey of IIMB, it was found that 45% of the people marked for the punctuality, that is, it had a delay in its flights. Then 20% of customers found it that Kingfisher Airlines were not that safe, and it did not give much attention to the safety of its customers. And other factors such as food, leg space, and comfort were also not up to the mark. So these were the reasons of marketing failure. Now the next slide, thank you, and now the next slide would be presented by my friend Sai.
Thank you, Sanjana. So now talking about the financial challenges, starting with bank dues, in 2014, the United Bank of India had announced Mallya as willful defaulter. As you can see in the table, Kingfisher Airlines defaulted almost 13 banks in India. Going ahead with fuel dues, as you can see in the table, almost 50.58% of revenue was utilized for fuel expenses. As the consequences of missing the deadline for fuel dues, Bharat Petroleum Corporate Limited had stopped selling jet fuels to Kingfisher Airlines. Going ahead with aircraft rental dues, Kingfisher lost almost 6 planes over non-payment of lease rental. A US-based leasing company took back 4 of its Airbus planes following non-payment of lease rental. Airport dues. Kingfisher Airline owed 40% of the airline dues to airport authority. Visually, all domestic airlines owe money to the state-run airport authority of India. But Vijayamala's Kingfisher Airline, now which is inoperational, accounted for over 40% of the amount owned by all the airlines. In this case of Kingfisher, the amount due also includes interest of rupees 121 crore. A recovery suit has been filed in the court for the whole amount. Going ahead with delayed salary. Private carrier Kingfisher Airlines had warned its 6,000 employees of delay in salary. The private carrier, which is reeling under the debt of almost 8,000 crore, had also trimmed the fleet from 89 to 69. The airline had sent an email to the employees that it is in a tight situation and the salaries may be delayed. This was not the first time that Kingfisher was delaying the salaries, but it was the first time that it formally informed the employees about the worsening cash flow situation. Talking about the service tax dues, Kingfisher Airlines continues to default on its service tax dues amounting to over 60 crore, and the government moved to FDI in the civil aviation sectors, offering the only ray of hope, covering the dues from the debt-ridden airline. As the airline stated defaulting on tax payments, the department started freezing its account. Now the fifth question will be explained by my friend Blessing.
Thank you, Sai. As my group members had mentioned about the financial crisis, the major takeaway is that there was no financial stability. Financial stability could have definitely been improved operation for Kingfisher Airlines. Secondly, Deccan Airways was basically a low-cost carrier where Kingfisher was a premium one. So Kingfisher took the Deccan Airlines, but there were many conflicts regarding the operations and the cost. The company bought Deccan at a price much more higher than its value, and it turned adding to financial stress on the company. This led into a spiral effect of financial troubles. In turn, Kingfisher Airways suffered from operational management. Thank you, ma'am. That's all from group number